I'm going to start this by asking a simple question to our three esteemed panelists. You know, they are all, including myself, have been focusing on growing our companies across the last two or three decades, and that shows how old we all are, okay? It would be great for us to share our journey from concept to the level of growth we have reached today briefly, and more importantly, touch on the way business landscape of India has changed alongside, and how it has changed, and is it today more acclimatized to growth, or was it before? So I'd like to start with anybody who'd like to take the table and sir.
As we say, ease of doing business, make in India, there's a leap forward. At least the atmosphere is being created for a better growth. I'm not saying that we have been able to achieve that, but atmosphere is being created for a better growth. Secondly, the two things on financial front, what they have done, increasing the credit guarantee limit by 1 crore to 2 crores, and also allowing NBFCs also to pitch in, because even the NBFCs will get the same guarantees, which is a great thing. Because, you know, small scale was always suffering from timely and inadequate finance. We were always talking about adequate and timely finance, and we were never getting it in time. So that was one. Second is marketing. Now brand marketing we are talking about. But this was also a concept earlier, you know, when Mr. Jena was the minister. Okay, we should have clusters and we should have same brand and we should market that brand. So the area with one product, one village type concept was there. But it didn't take shape. I hope it takes shape. Secondly, small scale, the issues are the same. When we make a representation to the government, for last 20 years, at least I know, that some of the issues are the same and the common and still remains unresolved.
If I look at the last 20 to 30 years, I think doing businesses in India has become much easier in a lot of ways. The infrastructure in India has improved. We still keep complaining about the infrastructure, but the roads have become better. Internet and connectivity has become better and we all use it. So if you look at the last 20 to 30 years, I feel that in India, two or three things have changed fundamentally. One is infrastructure. Two is the advent of media. 20 years ago, you didn't have, or 30 years ago, you didn't have television in its you know, broad way. That has changed a lot of how you market in India, if you are like a consumer product like ours, like Hawkins, the way we market. The third thing that's changed substantially in India is that the competition has actually increased. For example, in our industry, when we make pressure cookers, it doesn't take much to make a pressure cooker. And, you know, you all have heard of Hawkins or something like that, but what is the facts are, about 50% of pressure cookers in India are made by, you know, very small industries. The, what we call the unorganized market. But, I mean, they make pressure cookers, they're part of the market. I mean, they are, I mean, unorganized is only people like us calling it unorganized. They are as much a pressure cooker as anybody else. So the competition has increased, the infrastructure has become better, and so in some ways it's become easier to do business, and in some ways it's become more difficult to do business. But I think the business has become better.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Most of the SMEs are run by the entrepreneurs because they are passionate about it. And generally, I have seen if you are driven by a passion, then it's not too much troublesome. So what changed for us is in the initial days when we started, we borrowed at something like 21% from SIDBI. Now we have come down. The interest rates have substantially come down. It has come down to, I think, 8.5% in today's time. And with some subventions, it has gone below 6% actually. So India is now at the borrowing rates, which is globally competitive. We are borrowing at the almost same rates companies in the United States are borrowing, if you are having the right financial structures. So that has changed substantially. Frankly, we are leading the world when it comes to polymer processing. India is one of the most developed polymer processing countries in the world. So technically, that has given us an edge. So I feel SMEs are kind of those seeds, like unless I think most of the companies do travel this path, people become small company and then they become large. Like I've not seen many companies just be started as a large companies. Mostly they start as small and then grow up. So it's a wonderful journey. It is exciting. You meet a lot of people, you get matured. You don't learn too many things during your college education or a school education, which you learn during this process. For me, it was a very enriching, simple, and happy journey.
Thank you. Thank you so much. So Make in India, this is part of the theme today, is coined a term which has been recently coined, but it's been around for many years, as we all know, right? But each one of us here has in some way or the other been doing something which has been made in India and been innovating to compete in the global markets. So what I would like to understand from each one of you is, what is it that you all have done in your businesses which was Make in India maybe 20 years ago, is now currently branded as Make in India, which has helped you compete and succeed in the global market? And what were the challenges you faced while you were implementing these ideas? So can I start with maybe you, Sir?
Hawkins started off as this product was a British product. The pressure cooker was made by a British company called LG Hawkins of Drury Lane, based in London. And this Indian company was a sort of commissioner who used to make the cooker and sell it in India. However, what happened was, the pressure cooker started doing well in India, and in about 5 or 6 or 10 years, the British company shut down and it got sold to some other companies. Finally, somewhere in the 80s, the Indian company, because it was doing well, actually bought the brand name from the British company. It was no longer British, it was with Philips of Eindhoven at that point of time. And then, I mean, so since 1959, we have been making the pressure cooker in India. We have always made in India. We have never imported a single cooker or even a single component. We have, one thing we have imported is material. And that is one of the problems you have in making in India. Sometimes you don't get good raw material, so you have to go and import good material if you want to have good quality. Challenges of making in India are mainly, at least from our point of view, how to deal with the government.
You mentioned how do you deal with the government. So now, in this forum, I'd love you to ask, what is it that you would like the government to do to make it easier for budding entrepreneurs and existing SMEs to do business in India and compete in the global space?
There are two things which in India is a problem. One is, it is a fact, we must accept that businesses in India are also desperately trying to fool the government. It's not just that the government is only putting a spotlight on you and troubling you and all that. It is also true that we do not want to pay taxes. We do not want to, we want to avoid all sorts of things that we can. And that is I'll give you Hawkins' example, and I think it is connected with the earlier story of how to go from 1 million to 100 million. It's unlikely that you are going to be able to go from 1 million to 100 million by bribing the government. Very unlikely, because most of your attention and your focus will be caught by that process. Now he is making a product, I am making a product. Unless we can make a product which is best in the world, who is going to buy from us, or why should they buy from us? Today, there is no reason anybody should buy from you if you are not either the cheapest in the world and acceptable quality, or the best quality in the world with an acceptable price. You don't have a middle option that, you know, I'm... So for the government, what we expect the government is, don't trouble industry unnecessarily. And ensure that your officers don't do that. If an industry is not paying taxes, of course, deal with that. There is no harm in that. But, you know, some of the times they are, you know, the whole demonetization exercise and all that. Sometimes they just unnecessarily trouble you.
I think government should govern and we should do business. Both of us should be fidel and loyal to the system and would do our things.
Okay. Thank you.
Just say the same.
Sir, from your perspective?
No. As I said, when the new government took charge and they coined this Make in India and all, they also announced one more thing, that minimum government, better governance,
okay,
which has been not implemented.
That's what you
want. As we say, keep off government, we are not saying keep off government. But minimum government, better governance.
Okay.
So maybe do that. So that will see that the growth is there.
Okay.
And I'll tell you, when we are talking about digital India, when we are talking online, why not have most of the things online? Why you want to have personal inspections? Why you want people come to you? Why you want people worry you time and again? See, small scale is a single entrepreneur. He does everything by himself. There are very few companies who are very big and professionalized.
Right.
And I'll tell you, small have grown big and small will grow big if you allow them to grow big. And they will do that because they have an ability and capability. When they can work within these circumstances, they can do much better if you give them a better environment. And our transaction cost has to go down. As you rightly said, our transaction cost is very high. Rather, even the infrastructure, if we improve our infrastructure, whether port to delivery to connectivity to railway, road, your transaction cost will come down. Today, India is 6% of the GDP transaction cost, whereas world over it is 3%. So if it comes down to that, we'll be more competitive in the world than required.
Okay.
Sure. A short thought on what you asked about the government. It's a little bit of a weird thought, but I think it makes sense. The government is the lawmaker. They should write the laws better.
Mm-hmm.
You know, in India today, as soon as you read any piece of law, you can interpret it in 30 different ways. Because it's written like that. It's not written. So as a business, this thing, Weights and Measures, when you read Weights and Measures Act, you don't know what font size should it be, what should you write, because wo aise draft karte hain ki aap, matlab you, even if you want to comply, you cannot comply. Some inspector can always catch you and say, this you have not done. So that's what the government can do.